internet, glossy monitor, or matte monitor?
Glossy.
What's right? Matt.
Glossy.
Hey, internet. Gordon, I'm with PC World here. I'm here with Connor of Graphically Challenged.
Graphically Challenged.
You know him. You see all his super strong opinions on graphic cards. Go there, like and subscribe, and of course, click that bell button. You got to do that. I don't know why. It doesn't work otherwise. But if there's one thing I know Connor feels stronger about, it's his glossy monitors.
That's right.
Which is kind of funny, because I'm a hardcore matte monitor. I don't like the glassy finish. It's always shiny. Come on. Why would you?
Gordon.
I don't want to stereotype, Connor. I don't want to stereotype.
Okay.
Because you look younger than me. And young people play a lot of games, watch a lot of movies. I'm older. I got to sit in office, browser. I gotta have my mat. I get the glossy. What does that get me? That gets me nothing.
All right, I'm gonna explain to you.
He can call me old.
Yeah, all right, old man. I'm gonna explain to you exactly why you want a glossy monitor. Now, I will preface this with, I don't think matte is always bad. I think it does have a place, and I think like specifically if you're talking about budget displays or like an actual office you walk into, where you go and you do your spreadsheets all day. I think it's okay in those scenarios. We're talking 1080p, 1440p max. But if we're talking OLED, if we're talking 4K, if we're talking high pixel density, I really do truly believe that glossy is the way to go, and I'll tell you exactly why. So when you get to these high density displays or these displays that have amazing contrast, when you put a matte finish over it, not only does a matte finish not actually block reflections, it will diffuse them across the screen, so it'll make them less like irritable to you. But unfortunately, the side effect of diffusing light all over the screen is not only are you gonna get some sort of light hitting all over the screen if it's behind you, but it'll actually diffuse the light coming off the display itself, which can give it a kind of oily look to it. On the semi-matte finishes, it's not as bad, but on these heavy, heavy matte finishes, you can definitely notice when the lights are on, it'll give you kind of an oily look, and it'll even give you a little bit of like a grainy, sandy look over it. So when you're talking about like a 4K OLED, eventually, hopefully we'll get 4K OLED 32 inches, you got a really, really nice pixel density, looks really, really crisp, and then you get this oily, sandy look over it. I just don't think that when we're talking about premium displays, it's the right choice.
But you're talking about this oily reflection in your face, but when I think reflections, I think glossy finish. Because I got a shiny head, it shows up in the video, it shows up, it's just like the matte finish, it's just like, you turn the lights on, doesn't bother me. There's a window behind me, doesn't bother me. How does that even compete with glossy? Glossy is eye strain written all over it.
So I think it depends on like the placement of where you put it as well as like what your environment is like. I think there are times where glossy might not work for you. Like that's definitely fair to say. I will say this though, when you're spending a lot of money on a display and you're getting a really premium display, I do think it's worth having to put in the extra hassle that sometimes can be required, though to be honest with you, most of the time, maybe it's just my personal setup, but most of the time, even if there's light behind me, it just isn't that distracting to me. But if it is very distracting to you, I think it is worth putting in the time on these high-end displays to arrange your setup in a way where there won't be like an immediate clear reflection in that if it does bother you. I know some people do get really bothered, some people don't.
You know what? It's young people. They're willing to rearrange their lives around their phones.
It's worth it.
And their hardware, so I get it. You know, I do actually agree with you because I don't see too many high-end 4K beautiful panels that are matte.
No, you don't.
Especially that are, like, it's really, like, low-rent, right? It's only low-rent monitors and like, business monitors. And I do agree that, you know, the matte crowd is losing, so.
Thank God. And you got to keep this in mind, too. Like, you look at all the reviews for these OLED TVs coming out, and everybody loves it. The colors are so good. Has anybody ever said, you know what? I need an LG C2 with the matte finish. Now, maybe you've heard it. I've never heard it.
I will agree, because if you brought home a matte TV from Costco, you didn't buy it at Costco. You probably bought it more like, I don't know, at the corner drugstore, right? Yeah. It's just not, it is just, you're right, because the glossy is interpreted as high quality. It does look prettier, but I just, like for doing work, it just kind of, it just kills me to sit in front of a glossy monitor for a long time. What about a mid, is there a mid ground here? Because they do have these like, they
semi-matte.
Will have anti, well, they have anti-reflective coatings with these high DPI panels that are glossy. They give you that high luster look, but with the
I think those are like 99% of the time, those are completely fine. Like I do truly believe that like if you look at the Alienware, I can't remember the exact name right now. I'm sure it's got the whole alphabet in it, but that Alienware one, it's got some sort of coating on it. And it's not perfect because if you turn on the light, it definitely has issues where it really harms the ability for it to show you those inky blacks.
Right.
I think actually LG does it the best. They do have some sort of a diffuser on there, but it doesn't seem to really harm the picture in a noticeable way. It might do something to it. But you know, personally, when I look at those, like the LG C2, LG C1, and the C10, maybe I'm getting the names confused at this point, but you get my point.
It's late, it's Vegas.
Yeah, yeah. I think they actually look really good. And I think that's the way to go on the high-end displays. I think office monitors and $400, maybe even $500 and lower monitors, I don't have a problem with matte finish. I think semi-matte's probably a better way to go there. It's okay. Not as aggressive, but once we start talking about these crazy expensive monitors with these crazy high DPIs and contrast ratios, I think we really gotta go glossy.
What about laptops?
That's a good one. I'll be honest with you, I would have said matte in the past. I'm actually using the Raider GE67HX with the 240 hertz glossy OLED. Ooh, I don't miss going back to matte. I look at other laptops, and I could definitely see it being a problem because if you're really bringing it outside all the time or something. But at the same time, like you can pull your phone out. All your phones have glossy finishes, and it doesn't really bother me. Maybe it does bother some people, but for me, it's like glossy all the way, all the time.
Yeah, I will say in laptops, my only problem with, again, I like for a work laptop, I would prefer a matte finish because I want that anti-reflective just to absorb all the reflections. But my problem is when you get a laptop that has the glossy screen on a laptop that isn't touch.
Oh.
Because everybody goes glossy screen, you touch, and they start swiping your monitor, and you're like, what's wrong? And I have seen quite a few OLED panels, you know, because they're always OLED in laptops, and then they're not touch. It is kind of like a weird disconnect because matte is always non-touch, and then glossy is always touch. So I would say I would want matte unless it has to have touch. You got to have, if it's going to have OLED or glossy, it's got to have touch because then it's got the Gorilla Glass. But I'm going to say, you know, I'm not giving up. Right now I have a 32-inch 4K panel. It's matte. I'm not giving that up. But I would say maybe the next one, you're right. I have no choice. I have no choice because if I'm going to buy high-end panel,
try.
It's going to be glossy.
It's going to be glossy, and I'll tell you why it's going to be glossy because I will not rest until every single high-end display has a glossy finish. And if you want to argue with me, I will fight you. I'll fight you.
I still think I had some good points, but Connor has some really good ones too. And again, please go to his channel, Graphically Challenged, like and subscribe, smash that bell stuff, because he's got strong opinions.
I also got another channel, The Display Guy. That's, if you're really into displays, that's the one.
Okay, go to Display, is it just Display Guy?
The Display Guy.
The Display Guy, go over there, like and subscribe, and again, smash that bell somewhere down there. So anyway, come back to PC World's channel for more awesome content from CES 2023, and we'll see you later.